This is the Gus Pearson Natural Area, about 20 minutes out of town. Forestry professor and researcher Stephen Hart is studying decomposing leaves and the role they take in global warming. Hart's science focuses on the relationship between plant matter and the air we breathe. And like many scientists, he's concerned about CO2, or carbon dioxide.
Increasing CO2 concentrations in the atmosphere from fossil fuel combustion could actually result in plants growing faster, taking up more CO2, and then reducing the concentration of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, and then hence reducing its effect of warming. But that's only going to work if there's other key limiting nutrients for the plants to grow, like nitrogen.
So if plants have the right type of nitrogen, the kind which comes from these decomposing leaves, there could be more plant growth and less carbon dioxide in the atmosphere.
And so the whole purpose of our work was to try to understand what controls the rate of nitrogen release from senescent or dead plant material, which is a major source of nitrogen for the living plants. And so we found after this 10-year study a very elegant relationship that was independent of climate, independent of soils, that just you only had to know two factors. And one was the initial concentration of nitrogen in the material, which makes a lot of sense, but also the relative stage of decay that it was present in.
Hart co-authored a paper in the journal Science. It details the long-term study with plant matter from 21 sites in different climates. The professor says his area of expertise, ecosystem ecology, is especially complex, which is why he's so enthusiastic about results from this research.
In ecology, we don't have those kinds of things. We have a lot of hypotheses, we have a lot of theories, but to have this elegant relationship that can tell us how much nitrogen is going to be released and supplied to plants is amazing. So that was also amazing and just really surprising, because I didn't expect it to work out as well as it did.
Hart studied at UC Berkeley and Oregon State University and says he loves teaching and researching at NAU because of the ponderosa pine forest just minutes away. He says during a long class or lab, they can divide the time between the university and a research site.
It's a wonderful opportunity, and it's one of the reasons why I wanted to come to NAU, is for that, for the teaching and research proximity to the natural environment.
Hart is now comparing data from NAU's Gus Pearson Natural Area to the other findings in the 21-site study to see if pine needles react the same as other plant matter. He says he hopes this type of information will be used in global climate change models, so scientists can better predict how environments like this one will respond to global warming.